Hello everybody, this is Dr. Yasin Tayem. I am MD, PhD in Pharmacology and Therapeutics from the University of London. I am Associate Professor in Pharmacology and Therapeutics at the Arabian Gulf University, College of Medicine and Medical Sciences in Bahrain. In this video, I'm going to talk about problem number 4 in Unit 2, drugs for cough and sputum. Cough is a protective reflex to get rid of any foreign body, microbes or mucus from the airways. The most common causes of acute cough, which lasts less than 3 weeks, are the following: influenza, pneumonia, whooping cough, and irritant gases. Cough is also classified according to the production of sputum into two types: dry cough, which produces no sputum, and productive cough, which produces sputum. Chronic cough lasts for more than 8 weeks. The main causes of a chronic cough are the following: asthma, post-nasal drip, gastroesophageal reflux disease, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD, bronchiectasis, and cystic fibrosis. Physiology of cough. The cough center is located in the brainstem. It's in the medulla. Airway irritation, such as due to foreign body, infection, or sputum, sends messages to the cough center in the brain. The activated cough center sends messages to the chest wall and abdominal wall muscles to contract, and cough is produced to get rid of the sputum or microbes. Classification of cough and sputum drugs. Classes of cough and sputum drugs based on the goal of use are the following: antitussives, they suppress or stop cough; expectorants, they change dry to productive cough and increase the amount or volume of sputum to facilitate its release; mucolytics, make the sputum more liquid to facilitate its release without increasing its amount. Classes of antitussives based on the mechanism of action are the following: centrally acting drugs, they suppress cough by suppressing the cough center in the brainstem, such as dextromethorphan; peripherally acting drugs, they stop cough by suppressing airway sensitivity to irritants, such as benzotate. The following table shows the classes and examples on cough and sputum drugs. Centrally acting antitussives include dextromethorphan, codeine, and diphenhydramine. Peripherally acting antitussives include benzotate. Expectorants include guaifenesine and potassium iodide. Mucolytics include N-acetylcysteine and carbocysteine. Mechanism of action of cough and sputum drugs. Centrally acting antitussives. Examples: dextromethorphan. They stop cough by suppressing the cough center in the brain. They do so by decreasing the sensitivity of the cough center to the messages received from the airways. Peripherally acting antitussives, such as benzotate. They stop cough by decreasing the sensitivity of the airways to the cough stimulants, such as sputum. Expectorants, such as guaifenesine, they turn dry cough into productive cough and increase the volume of sputum to facilitate its release. They do so by enhancing goblet cells to release more mucus in the airways. Mucolytics, such as N-acetylcysteine, they make sputum more liquid to facilitate its release, but without increasing its quantity. They do so by breaking the bonds between mucus particles. Examples on the most important antitussives. Centrally acting antitussives. Dextromethorphan. It's an opioid, but it causes no addiction. It stops cough by suppressing the cough center in the brainstem. It is a drug of choice for dry cough. Adverse effects: CNS toxicity, GI tract upset, hypertension, and urine retention. It should not be used in children less than 2 years of age. Codeine. It's a centrally acting antitussive. Mechanism of action, same as dextromethorphan, but it causes addiction. Clinical uses, it's a second line drug for a dry cough after dextromethorphan. Adverse effects, severe constipation, CNS toxicity, GI tract upset, hypertension, urine retention, euphoria or dysphoria. It should not be used in children less than 2 years. The centrally acting antitussives, diphenhydramine, mechanism of action, same as dextromethorphan and codeine, but it causes no addiction. It's an antihistamine. It's a second line drug for dry cough after dextromethorphan. Adverse effects, constipation, dry mouth, CNS toxicity, drowsiness, urine retention. It should not be used if driving because of the drowsiness. Peripherally acting antitussives, benzotate. It causes airway anesthesia, making the airways unresponsive to irritation. It's a second line drug for dry cough after dextromethorphan. Adverse effects, dizziness, numbness in mouth and tongue. Examples on expectorants and mucolytics. Expectorants, guaifenesin. It increases the volume of sputum by enhancing goblet cells to release mucus and help release it outside the airways by enhancing the action of airway cilia. It turns dry cough into productive cough. It is a drug of choice for productive cough. Adverse reactions, GI tract upset, rash, and headache. Mucolytics, N-acetylcysteine. It makes sputum more liquid to facilitate its removal, but without increasing its volume. It does that by breaking the bonds between sputum particles so that it becomes more liquid or more thin. It is a drug of choice in diseases where sputum is very dry, such as cystic fibrosis, COPD, bronchiectasis, and postoperatively. Adverse effects, GI tract upset, stomatitis, rhinorrhea. Clinical pharmacology of cough and sputum drugs. Cough is a symptom of a disease. Therefore, the treatment of cough should be directed to the cause. Most cases of acute cough get better without drugs. But chronic cough is a major challenge, as the cause is chronic and sometimes cannot be cured. Dry cough is irritating to the patient and serves no purpose, as it produces no sputum. It should be stopped by using antitussive, and the drug of choice is dextromethorphan. Productive cough is protective, as it releases harmful sputum. Suppressing productive cough may be dangerous and should be attempted very carefully, and only if the quality of life is bad for the patient. The purpose of expectorants and mucolytics is the same, that is, to thin lung secretions, making them easier to clear by coughing and cilia reaction. However, for certain clinical indications, one of them is more effective. For example, a mucolytic is more effective than an expectorant in cystic fibrosis and COPD. Antitussives are sometimes combined with expectorants, such as guaifenesin plus codeine. This helps to make use of the value of both. That is, frequency of coughing is reduced by the antitussive, while the dry cough is turned into productive cough and the sputum is released easily by the expectorant.